Good morning. Welcome to Sacred Time, a contemplative prayer group from St. Richard's Episcopal Church in Winter Park. I'm Tiffany Lane. Today on this Tuesday in Holy Week, we're going to do a guided meditation based on the gospel reading appointed for today, for Holy Tuesday. It is John chapter 12, verses 20 through 36. So for this guided meditation, I'm going to ask you, first of all, to just relax. Sit very comfortably in your chair with your back straight, your feet on the floor. Just a general relaxed attitude, but be very comfortable. We're going to take very deep breaths. I want you to let go of the concerns that you have for this day, for this time that we're together. As we participate in this meditation together, we're all going to be using our intuition, we're going to be using our imagination, we're going to be using our senses, but particularly paying attention to what we hear, to what we feel, to what our responses are, to any questions that we may have while we're listening to the reading. And I will be putting this reading in present tense, because we are going to put ourselves in time and place, in away from our current time and place, but we're going to go back in time and put ourselves in Jerusalem in 33 AD. Okay? So let's start by just taking some deep breaths, and as we inhale, we're going to hold it for just a second. And exhale. And as we exhale, we're going to just expel all of our tension in our bodies. We're going to expel all the things we're worried about in this particular time. And just make an intention to be with God and with each other during this meditative time, okay? So get ready. We're going to inhale. Hold. Exhale. Inhale as deeply as you can, and exhale, inhale, exhale, and just relax, be comfortable. When I finish reading the gospel account, we're going to spend some time in silence. And during that time, I want you to meditate on what you hear, on what you may be feeling or what you have felt during that reading of the gospel, being present during this reading. Is there anything that stood out for you particularly? Anything that you might have heard a little differently than what you're used to? Anything that you maybe understood differently? Some new take on it? Based on the fact that we're going to imaginatively put ourselves in this time and in the midst of this gospel reading, okay? So, again, we're going to leave this time and place. Put yourself into Jerusalem, in the city, in the midst of this arid, hot desert community. It's the year 33 AD. Feel the heat. It's not Florida. It's not humid. This is an arid community. Look around you. Enjoy being in the city. What do you see? Who do you see? What do you smell? Is it quiet or noisy? Is it crowded or empty? Is it day? Is it night? How did you plant yourself in this time frame? So what are you doing? Are you an observer? Are you fully engaged in this time frame? There are large groups of people coming into the city because it's Passover. People are preparing for, for Passover. Among those groups are Jesus and his followers. And there's quite a crowd around him. Do you see them? Or are you part of the group? A hanger on? Or fully engaged with the followers of Jesus? Among the people who came into Jerusalem this week, you find that there are Greeks. And they're looking for Philip. Now you know that Philip is a disciple of Jesus, and he's from Bethsaida in Galilee, as most of them are. They encounter Philip in the street, and you hear them say to Philip, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip leaves you, leaves the group, and goes to find Andrew, who is also, you know, a disciple of Jesus. Andrew and Philip then leave to find Jesus, and they do find him and tell him that the Greeks are looking for him. You hear Jesus say to Philip and Andrew and to everyone that's surrounding him, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor." Jesus continues to speak. "Now my soul is troubled, and what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." A voice comes from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." You're standing in the crowd, and you know that you heard something. Some people around you say it was thunder. And you hear other people say, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answers and says, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out, and I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." And you hear someone in the crowd say, "We have heard from the law that the Messiah remains forever. Now how can you say the Son of Man must be lifted up? Who is this Son of Man?" And Jesus says, "The light is with you for a little longer. Walk while you have the light, so that the darkness may not overtake you. If you walk in the darkness, you do not know where you are going. While you have the light, believe in the light, so that you may become children of light." And you turn around and Jesus is gone. He has left very quickly. And you can't find him right now. deep breath. Stretch if you need to. So did you hear anything differently? Did anything stand out for you that you want to spend more time with today? How did you feel? Were there any questions that came up? Any confusion? Did you have a new way of maybe understanding, a new perspective of this particular gospel reading? How was it being present with Jesus and the crowd in Jerusalem in 33 AD? Take these thoughts with you throughout the day. You may come back to them on and off, but meditate on them throughout the day. Kind of chew on it a little bit and let it sit with you for a while. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next Tuesday at 10 o'clock for Sacred.